evening. This is Walter Brinkley reporting from New York. Tonight's subject is how to identify Republicans from a safe distance. Although declining in population over the past several years, Republicans still occupy wide areas of the country. So it is critical to distinguish Republicans before getting too close.
Hey.
Our report will investigate the telltale signs that Republicans are present. We will examine their habits and habitats. With us tonight is that respected commentator, Eric Chancellor, who will offer useful insights on how to manage Republican behavior. Eric? Thank you, Eric. We will begin by exploring the phenomenon of tea parties. These are the watering holes of today's Republicans. It is at these tea parties, or town halls, where Republicans gather to exchange considered views on the state of the country. For example, Republicans and Tea Partiers believe that Barack Obama was not born in the United States. Rather, they maintain he was actually born in the Republic of Kenya, which is just south of Oahu. Republicans and Tea Partiers distrust the legitimacy of his birth certificate and have used various forms of media to spread these doubts. Republicans are convinced that only they are competent to protect the country from terrorists. They feel Barack Obama lacks the necessary experience to keep the nation safe. Republicans dispute that anyone can defend the homeland as well as they. Therefore, Republicans strongly support enhanced interrogation techniques, such as waterboarding and sleep deprivation. Republicans believe that a strong military is necessary for national defense, and that national defense occurs thousands of miles beyond American borders. And it is there where diligent searching will uncover weapons of mass destruction. Therefore, Republicans support the war in Iraq. And the war in Afghanistan. And the wars in North Korea and Iran, as soon as they get started. To maintain strength in the military, Republicans oppose the repeal of Don't Ask, Don't Tell.
I always did like a man in a uniform. I should go up sometime soon.
You asked for it? I'm telling you.
Republicans, who have always been indigenous to the United States, greatly fear immigration, for all those immigrants must, of necessity, be Democrats. The question remains, however, what to do about them. Immigrants and Democrats. More border security has been suggested. Perhaps an insurmountable wall. Commentators urge that America be kept as American as spaghetti. It is perhaps on social issues where Republicans are most noticeable. Marriage between a man and a woman, and thus the sanctity of the American family, are exemplified by the Republican household. And then there is the question of faith. Republicans believe that faith is more than a personal relationship with God. Unlike mammon, it must be shared with everyone. Because of their strong belief system, many Republicans will not accept the theory of evolution. We now pause for this important message from our documentary sponsor. Shortly after the Bush financial bailout, Republicans were firmly opposed to financial bailouts. Eric, your comment, please. Thank you, Eric.
We're in the money. We're in the money. We've got a lot of what it takes to get along. We're in the money. The sky is sunny. Oh, man, depression, you are rude on our phone. We have seen it live.
And that is why Republicans support state right-to-work laws, as well as strongly oppose the Employee Free Choice Act. And despite the subprime lending crisis, the collapse of mortgage-backed securities, and the worthlessness of credit default swaps, Republicans continue to support the nation's free market, excluding any assistance that might benefit the workers in the auto industry.
See the USA in your Chevrolet. America is asking you to call. Drive your Chevrolet through the USA. America's the greatest land of all.
The Winter Olympics, held in Vancouver, British Columbia, focused the world's attention on a growing issue. Global warming. Republicans, even if they concede the point, strongly disagree that the rise in the Earth's temperature is man-made. Rather, they claim that these are natural occurrences, for example, Hurricane Katrina.
Oh, we're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. And here he is, the Wizard of Oz, if ever a wizard there was. If ever a wizard there was, the Wizard of Oz was one because.
Republicans were willing to filibuster to prevent the health care reform bill from passing. They contend that our health care system is just fine as it is, and, compared to other industrial Western nations, that the United States health care system is second to 21. In education, Republicans distrust the public school system, and to correct this, they suggest providing vouchers for students to choose their own schools. In order to preserve a well-regulated militia of one, Republicans strongly support the right to bear arms. Fortunately, since Republicans also endorse capital punishment, they can now eliminate all those surplus gunslingers. Republicans continue to remember fondly the years of Bush and Cheney. However, they now follow new stars in the conservative firmament.
Oh la la!
No, I'm tired!
Not the Melbourne method! Please hide me! Do something! You must help me!
Toto? We're not in Kansas anymore.
It is hoped that the preceding examples will assist you in recognizing Republicans from a safe distance. Should you find yourself in close proximity with one, it is advisable to not make any sudden moves nor criticize talk radio or the Fox News Network, as this can have significant adverse effects on Republicans. They may become enraged or worse. So remember, watch your step, keep your distance, and don't feed the conservatives. And now, for Eric Chancellor, this is Walter Brinkley in New York saying good luck and good luck.